Why, hello there, everybody. It's me yet again. I really do hope you're listening, and I really do hope that you're paying attention. And I really do hope that you realize that these people, they don't care about you. They could care less about you. They are so busy. And when I say, who's these people? The politicians and the news media. They are so quick to cut not only each other down, but insult us. Put a label on us. Put words in our mouth. Lie to us as well as lie about us. Deem us, vilify us, demonize us, villainize us, all in an attempt to control us. Remember who they are supposed to be. Politicians are supposed to be our public servants. They're supposed to be doing the will of the people. And if they would have just simply done their job, we wouldn't be having this conversation. We wouldn't be having this uproar. But the simple fact is they haven't done their job. They have lied to us, lied about us, divided us, segmented us, and pitted one group against the other, all in an attempt to maintain control. And why are they so nervous now? Why are they all teaming up on one person? Because one person is doing the one thing that we all wish we could do, stand up to them. Now, we all know it takes money to run. Well, Donald Trump had a whole lot of money. And if you notice now that they're even trying to say, well, what is in it for him? Folks, you all are missing the point. You politicians, you news media, Donald Trump is not doing this for him. He's a billionaire. He was not affected by all of these things that were going on. He was isolated. He wasn't affected by any of this. Do you really think that this is going to affect him? That the outcome of an election affects him? No, of course not. He decided, you know what, he saw who it was affecting, you know, you and me and his country. He did not like the direction that his country was going in. So, as an American citizen that had enough money to go out, he decided that he was going to represent the people. Look at what he's been talking about the whole time. Building a wall, keeping the Muslims out. Getting rid of Common Core, making better deals, putting America first. And when you listen to some of his rallies, you hear men, women, businessmen, businesswomen, ministers say, what is so wrong with wanting America and putting America first? Is it not our country? That's what they failed to see. So what did they do? They demonize him and they say, well, you know, he's selling his steaks, he's selling his wine. Folks, hello. The water company is for his properties. The vineyard, the wine company is for his properties. The steaks, you can't go into the store and buy a Donald Trump steak. You can't go in the store and buy Donald Trump water. You can't go in the store and buy Donald Trump wine. Because he doesn't sell it. He produces it for his own properties. That way he doesn't have to spend his money to go out. It's cheaper to make something for yourself than it is to go out and buy it from someone else who's made it. Wow! Concept. Brand new concept. That's why he's saying, we're going to build the stuff here in America, so we don't have to pay the import fees and everything. We're going to bring the jobs back to America. Now, folks, these people are so afraid of this man because he is an American. He's not a politician. He's just like you and me. And he's putting the America first. He didn't have to do what he's doing. But thank God that he is. Because now we can truly say we have a voice that isn't bought and paid for by Wall Street or by anybody. Big business doesn't own Donald Trump. He's there for you and me. Something to think about, folks.